Welcome. We are here at the Romanian Film Festival in Seattle. This is the 8th edition of the Romanian Film Festival in Seattle, but also the first edition of Arizona Romanian Film Festival. So these two organizations, together with Arts Detroit, hosted by the Northwestern Film Forum on Eventive, brings you this year 23 new film productions from Romania and Europe, showcasing the creative spirit and resilience of young or more established directors covering a wide range of genres, feature films, documentaries, and shorts. You can watch the films online through Northwest Film Forum, and you have the link in the chat or in the comments on the on Facebook. We have today with us Marian Crișan, the director of the campaign, and we are very grateful to have him with us here. I'm Marie-Louise Paulesc, the representative of the Arizona Romanian Film Festival and Arizona ARC, a very small organization that tries to promote Romanian culture to Arizonans, Romanians, and all the Arizonans. Thank you for accepting our invitation, Marian, to be with us and to talk to us about your movie, The Campaign. I would start by asking you, what is this movie? So one of the things that I've noticed was that The Campaign is listed as comedy, as drama, or some people not knowing where to go, they are listing it as both comedy and drama. In some places that you said that you intended it as a satire, and you talked about the absurd of the situations portrayed in the film. But some people who saw the film thought that it's so realistic. So what kind of movie is it?
Hello, and nice to be online with you, and thanks for inviting. The Campaign is my fourth feature film, and it somehow develops my my interest in stories and in a style that was called and is called the Romanian New Wave. These are realistic films that has this documentary look, like not want to dramatize too much, but to observe life and to observe characters and develop characters out of the real life. And this is the cinema that I like. These characters and this film is developed from observation of life in my hometown, Salonta, observation of characters like politicians or other characters that I wanted to bring on screen, not like you saw them in this cliche kind of way that the politician is a bad guy and a good guy and stuff like that. So, of course, when you go on a platform or you go on TV, then they will write their comedy or drama or whatever, satire. I don't write thinking about that. It comes out to be also comic, but also maybe very dramatic in the same time. So cinema is like that. I don't believe in a pure form or pure genre, that this is a comedy. This is a film. this is a long feature film made by me in my hometown. It's a really low budget. It's also with amateurs, with actors in small theaters in Romania, not stars. So it's the kind of cinema that we do. Yeah.
So you talk about the fact that it's based on observation, that you went and shot it in Salonta, which is your hometown. I'm curious actually about if you could take us a little bit behind the scenes, how was the filming in your hometown, and the interaction with the people there, and how you chose which characters, right, to kind of cut out of real life to integrate in the movie?
First of all, the script was based on some characters coming from a real life, so to say. Some parts of personality of different people, so to say. It's not a certain man that is the character, but there are some
composite
men, a group of people and a kind of character, this everyday guy in my hometown, this John Doe in my hometown. This is Viorel, the character that is the tractor driver. And I wanted to find a character that say something about the times that we are living and or we lived in Romania. So this tractor and this tractor driver is connecting the past with the present, because these tractors and these tractor drivers are symbols of communist Romania, so to say, of old Romania, that are still working today. And this nostalgia and this kind of communist nostalgia that we still have here is represented by this kind of a character that is out of this world, so to say, because now we have also the modern agriculture and we have farming and organic farming, but we still have these tractors from the 70s and these guys that keep on working on them. So I wanted to have a symbolic character as a main character, because this came together as a writing game. We imagined a politician coming in that small town, and we started to write scenes after scene, trying to bring observation from campaigns in Romania in the last 20 years. So this kind of a character, this 40 years old plus kind of guy, middle-aged guy that is anonymous and doesn't have a power in the community, is the kind of a character that I like to talk about or to write. So
why?
That was the beginning.
Yeah. So why is this particular type of character interesting to you?
It is because it, like I said, this is not the first thing that I do this. My first film is also about a character like this. Is a Dan in Morgan in my first film. The character was a low kind of bodyguard in a supermarket. This is another kind of character that you meet in Romania. This bodyguard with no power, this bodyguard for nothing, for the supermarket or the shop. So this kind of a character is somehow a symbol of a generation of Romanians that after the revolution didn't find their place, and they are now getting older, but they are not they don't fit in this new world. They are they used to work in the communist era, maybe in big factories or something like that closed, and they are like stuck in these times, and we have a lot of people here like this, mainly in the villages and in the small towns. People that don't fit, they are not useful anymore. The society doesn't need them, because they work in a system that is no more present. So But more than that, for me, it's very easy to write this character, this kind of a character. This is a man in his 40s, 50s. I'm also in my 40s. These guys are maybe a bit older, like in the 50s. But I write really easy about them because I connect intimately with this kind of people. I know how they think, how they talk, how they move. And I, it's all about that when you write. You need to feel them, to know how to, yeah, to describe and to make them talk.
And because we're talking about the characters, so we have Viorel, right? And then the politician, and you chose Ovidiu Crișan and Ion Sapdaru. Why these actors? What do they bring to the story and to the characters? Or how did you cast them in these roles, and why? Why these two actors?
Like I said, this was not planned to be a blockbuster, so we didn't go for the stars, so to say, because there are TV stars also in Iran. But I wanted to find the match for these characters, and Sapdar is pretty known. He's a pretty well-known name in cinema, but yeah, he's not a really big star. But he's from Iași, and I admire his work, and I knew he could do this politician, and. This is a thing that he didn't know, but I had him in mind when I was writing. That was a thing that was in our mind, that this guy comes from Moldova. This is East Romania, and we'll meet this guy in West Romania. These characters are also very different in temperament, in feeling, because East Romania is more quick and more nervous, furious, and West is slow and is like, I don't know, in states, maybe Texas or South are more, I don't know, they are different. They talk slower and they think more than talk. So also this is also funny, maybe not for an American audience, but in Romania, when you see this, when you watch this film, you also find this funny because they are like totally different parts of Romania that are on screen and they are funny in language. So I try to find two actors in that way, one from Moldova and one from Transylvania. So because I believe in this part of acting that they should be somehow characters, not to act, and to feel things that to feel something, some details in life more than in a text, so to say. Because acting in cinema is not the same as theater. Of course, it's different, and it's more about being there. And Ovidiu Crișan is also an experienced actor and a theater actor, but I was impressed by his power to transform, because he in real life is not like that at all. He's really fit and clean and kind of intellectual, but he could transform himself in this kind of peasant, almost tractor driver, and also it's about appearance, the physical physical appearance of the actor, from the face to the body. There is something there that cannot be acted, and because it's not theater, you need a kind of a movement and the body and body language that, and also skin that fits the character. I mean, this tractor driver is working in the land, so his skin is really tough, dirty, and the face is, and you cannot do that in makeup. So I look at that details when I try to find an actor, what he looks like in real. So Ovidiu, yeah, has this rough, rugged face that, yeah, was then put in this character. And also, Sapdaru has this kind of politician way of being somehow for me. So, yeah.
I mean, both of them, and we also have a question from the audience, and Marius, maybe you want to ask it yourself, but both of them are really great theater actors. That's how I actually saw them the first time. And I remember I saw Ovidiu, in his college production, and then Sapdaru, I've seen him in acting in Botoşan. So they're really great theater actors. And Marius had a question about these actors, and also about George Dometi. So do you want to ask it?
Sure. Thank you. First of all, congratulations on a great movie that we thoroughly enjoyed. I have to say, from the beginning to the end, follow the movie in a good Transylvanian way without any rush, slowly but surely. It was a pleasure. Thank you for this gift. Well, you took a chance, I would say, by casting actors who have a theatrical background. And I hope you don't mind me saying that occasionally it shows that sometimes they sound like they're on stage saying something for the people in the back row of the theater. But there was one exception which I thought was absolutely amazing. George Dometi, to me, was a revelation. He jumped in as a movie actor with no regrets, plowing forward, outstanding character. How did you get him? Where did you get this guy?
George Dometi is an actor, a theater actor from Oradea. So this is also what I did in films before. When I work in West Romania in Oradea or Salonta, I work with actors there because I believe I can bring them on screen even though they don't have too much experience. George is the first time on screen, and we did some testing with him for another part, not for that part. I felt he can do this part, that he's in the film, and that he's great, that he has a good good rhythm and a good energy. And of course, he fits there, and he's all the time on screen somehow. He's a kind of a revelation also for everybody, and for me also finding him. He's just beginning in theater for some years. He's also from Moldova. He's from Iași or something, but he works in Oradea in West Romania. So he's not the only one. Actually, most of the actors in the film are from Oradea, because we work with them very well, and they are easy to connect with the atmosphere.
As long as we are talking about actors, I would like to push this question of the actors that you instantly made from the people in Salonta, right? So how did you choose these moments? So for me, some really cool scenes when Mocanu talks with the lady on the bench, right? With old lady on the bench, and then also when he has the conversation with Ildiko in the cookie shop, right? So what about these moments?
The lady on the bench is of course is from the real life. She's living just two houses near. So we wanted to have a character like her, and when I know these people because I have relatives and I have a lot of friends living on those streets. When I was a kid, I was there. So We knew that we will find a old lady, because I wanted to be an old lady dressed like they used to dress in this black, and they staying on the bench. This is a typical Romanian moment. And she was really great. She came, she said, yeah, we'll do it. Some days before we send her the text, but it was not a problem. She's almost more than 90 years old, I think. She's like 95 or something. She's really old, but she didn't have a problem with the text. She came and said, okay, with an actor, it was really easy with her, because she had this talent to act the short moment for her. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she did it with like five takes we had it. So she's a great moment for me, maybe one of the greatest moments in the film. She is that moment, because I know her personally, and I know that it's a thing that will stay on screen. That is real Salonta. Yeah, and the cookie shop, it's not real. It's also an actress from Oradea, a Hungarian speaking actress. But as you observed, the film is done like that you feel that these are moments took out from the real. That is what we wanted. That you have the feeling that it's not something dramatic in the cookie shop. It's just a dialogue. But there's something there in the cookie shop the next time Mocano comes. So it plays with his feelings a bit, even though it's not important in the beginning, maybe. But for him, it's something that he misses. He's alone, and the next time when he will come in the cookie shop, you will see a different Mocano.
And there was also the punch cake. So I'm guessing that's one of the reasons he went back, right?
Of course.
You said that the lady on the bench is one of the greatest moments in the movie for you. What are some other great moments in the movie for you?
Yeah, another scene that I liked to shoot and it was interesting to shoot was at the farm when he meets also this old man that tells the history of Romania in three minutes. This old actor also was a great moment to work with, because also this is a professional actor, but it was really hard for him to have all this text. It was even longer than in the film, but he memorized it. This is also a really interesting location that shows these fields around Salonta, or this farm where they go. This is also about the landscape of Salonta that I really involve in my films, and I like to go out of the town and to see this line of horizon and this old small farms around the town. This almost looks like Australia or some Western scene, because there is nothing on those fields, grass or something, and these small houses.
Well, if I'm allowed to say, for me, one really cool theme throughout the movie were those scenes where Viorel and it would be a pity not to mention Maria Junghietu as well, when they go to bed and they have those very brief dialogues that kind of punctuate the story. And we're getting to also talking about this, because we're talking about the story, and we have a question from Marius again. The idea, the title of the movie was for a while The Berliner, right? So how did you choose between, or why did you choose The Campaign rather than The Berliner for the movie?
Yeah, it was the sales. Actually, the world sales. They needed the more generic title, more commercial, and and I say, okay, if you believe it will be more commercial for you, then yeah, we'll change it to The Campaign, because Berliner somehow maybe take you into another direction, but yeah, in Romania the film is released as Berliner, and I like more Berliner, and I think it has more than The Campaign, but yeah, it's about the commercial side of films. Make it more commercial, The Campaign. Everybody will understand it's a campaign.
and you know, because we actually the that moment that inspired, I guess, the title of the movie, that moment when, you know, I am a Salontan, right? It's a memorable one as well. Coming back to the story and to this idea of the politician who gets there and gets to use all of these people to stage his campaign. I don't know why, but to some extent, I felt like the story is maybe a little mean with the people in Salonta who allow themselves to be used in this way, and there's very little resistance to what this guy is doing and how he's using them for his political campaign. So I guess let's get into a little bit into, you know, what is this movie telling us about this world and about this society, right?
Yeah, it's hard to say what it's supposed to tell, but somehow it tells about how we are corrupted without even knowing it, or without realizing that we may be manipulated, because and somebody comes and say, let's take a photo. Yeah, you take a photo and that's it. But that this small gesture and this small moment can be part of a bigger manipulation. And also we are talking about manipulation through these little images that are put together on our phones, and how they are put together. We don't see the photos, and we don't see the actual people looking at the photos or the effect. We don't see that, but we see how they stage all these small fragments of emotions. Let's take this little girl embrace this little girl, go to this old man, talk to that. We'll take photos of this citizen near his bike. Things like that, that are put together for us, the electorate, the voters, to see that these guys are human, that these guys are have feelings. The image with the little girl that is holding embraced. I think it's in every country, in every campaign. You will see a politician with a small kid in his arms. You will see that. I mean, this is part of the basic human emotion. I think we had this photo of Ion Iliescu with this little girl that won the election in 92. I mean, these are powerful images that are made, of course, are made of. And now they are even more than words, because they are everywhere. So these guys do this. These guys manipulate through this new thing that is, the Facebook. And they say, people don't need words, they need images. And they follow these likes growing through what they do. But what the film actually says politicians are also human, that they have their life and they are ruthless. They will do their job. They are professional. This everyday guy is manipulated slowly, and he becomes part of the system, of the machine, without even realizing, or he realizes, but he is he thinks he's right. He doesn't feel he does anything wrong taking the last vote. So this is what interested me. How about the conscience of doing these kind of things of the voters that we do, not the politicians, the voters that take these small decisions of taking something or taking a bribe or saying something, and they go to bed, they say, I did nothing wrong, and maybe they did. So it's about politics of the small people, not the politicians.
Ilana has a question about the point of view, the perspective.
Yeah, thank you, Marian, for this great movie. Otilia and I actually talked about it with our students and presented it to a class, and we'll have a conversation later on. But for me, while I was watching the movie, I was struck because of the editing. In some of the shots, I felt like an intruder in the bedroom of Viorel and his wife in the small talk before turning off the lamp. And in others, I felt, okay, I'm part of the public now. And so my question to you is, whose point of view do we want us, the viewers, to see? Several points of view, or how did you work with the camera to make us feel in some places as intruders, in some other shots as part of the public, or invited even, not only as part of the public?
Yeah, it's not different, the intimate parts and the public parts. They are the same because it reflects the moment. The moment it's intimate, of course, in the bedroom, but we are looking as in a mirror. We don't edit, and we don't shoot the characters like you are used to in a film, with close-ups, and with close-ups edited to another close-up, and then with an established shot. We don't do that. It's more like a steady observation from a distance all the time. And of course, if you are in a public, like in the schoolyard, in the school, or at the manifestation, or so, then of course you will get that. But when you are in a moment with two guys, or for example the moment with the politician walking on the street meeting the old lady, the camera is moving really slow, like the politician. It doesn't want to show you nothing like details of the old lady working, or the close-up. You don't see the politician. It's from behind. So it follows a kind of a rhythm that it's established from the beginning. From the first shot, you establish a rhythm, and it's like in music, you establish that kind of a rhythm and themes, and then you go with that till the end. And it's about that somehow for us. And the cuts are also vital, because it's the editing is the thing that puts everything together. I mean, you establish the rhythm in the editing. The most of the shots in the film were longer than this, than you saw them. But we established this beat and these cuts that are sometimes violent. They get you out of the scene. It's like changing channels. They just in a gesture or in a kind of move, you cut. It's the final shot. It's the most relevant on that. And all this film, all the film is built to go on that shot, on that cut. That is also a cut that it doesn't tell you, it doesn't give you a key that, well, this film is about that, but it it puts you in a place near those dancers, that everything is in circles and bam. And it's a thing that we feel together with DOP and the actors, and we'll take this like this, and we try to find this perfect point of view all the time. For every scene, we try to put the camera in the vital point, and that's it. It's like then it's a theater play. We are there, and we observe that scene, and it somehow sometimes it's alive, sometimes it's.
Thank you. It was really helpful to understand what exactly you're doing, because it's such a rich film, truly. I mean, as Marie-Louise said at the beginning, it belongs to several genres, depending on where you want us, the viewers, from which point of view you want us to see the film. And because you're talking about the baby holding cliche of the politicians, I think you pushed that cliche further when you filmed the politician holding that kind of big girl, so that she was not a baby. And I felt awkward. My God, this is a Romanian Lolita. What are you doing?
Yeah.
And because we had too, the infant and then the big girl.
Yeah, that's what they found that morning. Yeah. Yeah, it's also about that, things that are not really, professional.
Yeah, it was excellent. That was a satire for me, a moment of satire. Politicians would go to whatever length it takes to promote himself, no matter how ridiculous that promotion is. It feels like, as they said, no commercial is that, Maybe Marie-Louise,
there is no bad publicity.
Exactly, no bad publicity. Yeah. That was the moment for me. Yeah. No awkward publicity.
I have a question about, I noticed the variety of accents. It was so refreshing to hear, all the, accents from Transylvania, from Moldova. And we noticed with Diliana, as we were watching the film with our students, of course, American students, that will miss this, richness, of the politician who controls himself and he loses his Moldovan accent, and it's really remarkable, And can you comment a little bit on the role of language and dialects and accents in this film? And you have the Hungarian as well, so it's very rich. Yeah.
This is in this film and language theme, so to say. It's in I think in all my films, because I'm interested in this. I'm interested that the characters are talking their language, their dialect, and also I want to be really local, because even though it's international and you see it in the United States or in Germany, you will feel that something is there. Because and it's important for me that when I hear it to be like poetry, to be like a popular song, like a folk song, like a folklore. I believe in this, and I like that every character should talk his dialect and his language, and it's part of the character and part of the location, so to say. I mean, I think this is also in France, or you need to be true, and it's hard for the actors, because not all of them are from that part. For example, Maria Junghietu, she's not from Transylvania, and was quite hard for her. But we had a kind of a coach of some ladies on that street that I said, Maria, please stay with these ladies all the time, and you should live with them for some days, and just hear them talking, because they have a kind of flow that you will need to have. It's not a mechanic. I don't need that you just say this kind of in an accent, but I need you to have this flow. This da na na na. They have a kind of talking, and they talk a bit more than the guy, than the man in that town. The women talk more, and they, even though it's transient, they talk more, and they talk in a certain way. And I needed that to sound like that for Maria. Of course, the politician has this Moldavian, but also Bucharest kind of capital city kind of talk, because he's used to be a minister. But when he's intimate, he's more Moldavian also. And this also was hard, because Ion wanted to have this mix of Moldavian and Bucharest language. I wanted it more like Moldavian, even though he was right, but he wanted to have this Bucharest part in the Moldavian. And it was tricky, but yeah. I think he managed, but yeah, it's. I think this is also cinema. The cinema is also about this, about reflecting ways of living and talking, and or in a certain place and in a certain time, because we record also that. It's not just a genre film that is supposed to be pure entertainment. This is also a ethnographic, has a I think is a document for me, is a document of the place and the people. I mean, I think it will stay that when you look at this film some years after, you'll say, yeah, this is from that place, and this shows how the people live in those places for real, like they what they have, what kind of a bicycle they have, what kind of a tractor, how they dress, how they used to receive guests, what they put on the table, what do the old lady do? I mean, maybe in some 50 years, you will not understand what does that lady do. So for me, it's important that I document that.
I have regarding this, so you mentioned new Romanian new wave, the Romanian new wave at the beginning, and the new wave is legendary for, you know, filming in closed spaces, in the apartment, in the kitchen, in the city, in the apartment building. So we feel like kind of suffocated by the, you know, by the closed space. And now, you know, you brought the characters in the countryside. And I noticed there is an there's other films at the Romanian Film Festival this year, Între Galde and No Rest for Old Lady, where the action takes place in the countryside. And there is some fascination, you know, for the life of those, you know, older people, you know, who live in the countryside and who are probably, they're carriers of different values and different ways of life, you know, that maybe a city person that was more prominent in the new wave, you know, doesn't have anymore. And there's, can you comment a little bit? Is this something that you noticed? Is there a new interest for, changing locations? And does it reflect the gap between the city and the...
This is not new for me. I mean, my first film was the same. It was 2010. So it's 10 years before worked the same. I mean, all my films have nature in landscape, all the four films. And for me, location is very important, and the air and the landscape, I try to put a dramatic part in it all the time. I mean, it's true that in this, maybe this year, you have some films outside, not inside, but I will not say that this is the most important thing in the new wave, that they were in the apartments. They are not all like that. And of course, this is a important in this new wave, because they shot the films in Bucharest, most of them. And Bucharest is block of flats, apartments. Mm-hmm. So the stories came from these apartments. And of course, you had this claustrophobic side of them, because they were real. And I think it's important, it's really important that in after the 2000, we saw these apartments and these interiors in different, because till then, most of the film were not realistic about what people really did in these apartments, how they feel, how they lived, how they talked. They were really theatrical, the 90s films. And so it's important that the generation in 2000 came and put again the camera in these interiors, and you could feel you see Romania, you watch Romania.
Thank you.
Talking about trends, I guess, and projects and what you're doing, what you have done in the past. How about if we are looking a little bit towards the future? What are you working on right now?
Yeah, I don't want to say too much, because it's you never know what future will bring. But I'm working on a totally different kind of story. It's a story set in World War II, but it's also set in West Romania, in the mountains, and it tells some moments in the end of the war, from some memories of my grandfather. That used to be a kid back then, and I imagine a story of a kid and his horses on the top of the mountain at the end of World War II. And this is a story that is again, intimate, because I try to start all the projects from something that I really feel, that I believe, or it's intimate to me personally. Not the story, but the core, the characters or something there that it's, for me, it's important to tell. Not a major event, but something that keeps me curious to develop for years, because a film, of course, it's and in our situation is even harder, takes two or three years to make, and you need to have this this fire, this small fire all the time till the end. And that's how, when we start a film, for me it's really important this seed to be really tough, and then after 3 years you finish the film. So we'll see.
It's really interesting. You're talking about the fact that it's not big events, small events, your characters and the movie now and what you're thinking about doing. And you're also emphasizing observation. And I guess what I'm trying to ask is, at least with this movie, with the campaign, right? We're observing a town, as I said, used by the politician. And of course the whole thing is repugnant in some way, right? But it's not evil, and it's like, okay, it is what it is kind of thing. But it still kind of left me with a feeling of no hope. But if we were to talk about hope, what is the hope when it comes to Romanian society, Romanian politics? What is the hope?
Yeah, I mean, this is really tough for me to answer right now, because you know, like I know, and we are really, really concerned for what's happening now in Romania, just now. So, and this is also politics. So it's really hard to tell. I mean, for our generation, for me, what happens now, not last year or not 2 years ago, it's really frustrating. I mean, what happens now, it's after 30 years of hope. And it's hard to explain for an American, but you know what I mean. I cannot say anything about politics and hope now, and I don't even wanted to make a film that changes somebody, or to make a film that stands for liberal or social beliefs. No, this is a film about people caught in this campaign, and it keeps on going. That we still dancing, and we still voting, and I don't know. I think maybe this film, the campaign, will tell something different next year. I don't know. For me, we try to keep busy in doing films.
Yeah, I was, I was trying to bring the conversation on a higher note, but I totally see what you're saying about hope and politics in Romania.
Right? Yeah. These days in Romania, I mean, we are really down. For real.
I guess then the question is, in this context, what can you as a MOVE director do? What are the kinds of changes you hope to accomplish with a film like the campaign, with the film that you're working on right now?
Actually, we are not activists, and we don't want to change the world by doing films. But what I wanted to say is that we are not talking about politics enough with the artists. The artists are not debating in their art politics. There's more about I don't want to say anything that can hurt somebody, but in films it seems that in films we don't talk about politics. I mean, you don't have political films. This is not a political film. This is a comedy satire on politics. But in general, people are not involved in artistically talking about this issue. I mean, you cannot say too many films in Romanian films, for example, that talk about politics. I mean, politics is only on TV. It's only on TV. It's only on newspapers. And what I wanted to do is to bring it a bit in cinema, to see, let's see these characters that, like in cinema, these politicians you only see on TV. You only see on TV fighting on talk shows. You don't see them living, but you have a lot of characters in the films, but no politicians. Or if you have them, they are really bad and where they come in, they are really, evil. So I believe that people should be more conscious about politics and to see that politics can affect their life. And when they vote, it matters. It's not, in Romania, we had elections that were bought. A lot of voters were bought with small amounts of money. And this is not democracy, this is not politics, but it happens. And this is because we are not talking enough about it, I think.
I would like to invite the audience if they have more questions. I see one here. And you talked about the voters and voting and politics and the lack of conversation in politics. Gabi is asking, do you think that uninformed or uninterested voters yield too much power? Do you think perhaps voting rights should be earned? And then Marius has another question. The question about voting is, do you think that uninformed or uninterested voters yield too much power? Maybe voting rights should be earned?
No, I don't believe that. But it's something real. And this is what I'm saying. People are not involved in politics. They are involved only one day in four years when going to vote. And then we have these campaigns before the voting that is like a circus of politicians fighting and promising and stuff, and the citizen that just looks and say, okay, I go with these guys, they are great. But this is not politics. That's why I created also this script, and we wrote this script also about this, to make people see what happens, because maybe if they see a bit more, then they know all this stuff, but they don't they don't accept, they don't, they go again and they are corrupted for in the next elections. So I think people should be more informed and should be more conscious that their vote matter, and their vote and their option is important. It's not something like, I don't care, give me a pack of cigarettes and I'll vote. I mean, this is not healthy.
If I may. I would suggest to move the discussion from the realm of politics, which is very difficult, and we all know it's quite a sensitive, to the one of morals. And I want to thank you for making this movie that, to me, conveyed a very powerful message, which is once you give in into accepting a gift, a free gift, as I say, there is nothing more expensive than a free gift. You give in your entire life. So when Viorel accepted a free tractor, he somehow got trapped into helping Silvestro further down the road, which is what he did. He got him a lot of votes, even from deceased people and so on. So this is a moral aspect of life in all countries, not only in Romania, that I think the movie brought up in a very, very good way. And the question to you is, as the movie progressed, I feel that the relationship between Silvestru and Viorel evolves, it gets stronger. Was that a reflection of the actors getting closer, friendlier together, or not? Or was, I don't know how this was shot in chronological order or not, but it seemed to me that they got closer as individuals. And indeed, as Silvestru said very well, here's how it works. I help you, you help me. That's a very dangerous way in life. But did the actors get along better and better during the film shooting?
Yeah, they did. And somehow we like to work quite chronologically. Also, because of that, because you need the humanity to grow in a team. Because it's not about all the time it's acting. It's also about chemistry, and you need to build that, of course. And you don't start with the last scene, and you don't start with the most emotional scene, because they need few days just to enter the rhythm of talking and the moving. I think, I mean, if I look at all my films and I look at the first 3 or 4 days of shooting, they are not working really well. But after all 5 or 6 days of shooting, they start to get the rhythm between them, and it evolves. This is probably true in every shooting. And I mean, what I like and what I like to do with actors and playing with them is make them feel the character also after the shoot, during the day, and to stay in the character, to dress like the character, to be more in the shoes of that character all day long, not in the shooting. I mean, I kept telling to Viorel to keep his way of moving and of acting all the time, even in the breaks, and we go for a beer, or we go meet a real tractor driver, people in the village, or then we go, and Viorel should be the same, should be Viorel, not Ovidiu Crișan, and should talk with them and have this and it's like a chameleon, kind of. You take something from the people that you are near. So also you have a really of course really good observation about the moral issue, and of course I think this is also about films and cinema, and about you need to go a bit further than the first layer, because you can, but it's not only the proposal in the beginning that makes it the moral issue. That is the start, but the finish, the end of the film, and the last scenes in the film gives you another dimension of this moral thing, because it's something there that you feel it's wrong, but you don't know what.
We have a, because we are talking about the story of the movie and the moral, we have a question from one of our viewers on Facebook. So why is the story shot in Salonta? You talked a little bit about this, but why? This is not the only movie that you shot in that area. Why there? Why do you go back there?
Yeah, why does Scorsese film a lot in New York? That's why.
That's fair.
Yeah, it's for me, Salonta is New York. It's of course this film, I think, can happen in every in many small towns in the world, not in Romania, maybe in Czech Republic or in Russia or in Eastern Europe. But I wanted to be a small town, that's for sure, because I wanted to go with these people that are far from the big cities and far from the politics or these crowded places. So I needed to go in these houses that people are living quietly, and they're going from election to election in the same with the same way of living. For them, all the promises and all these debates on TV has no effect on their being more wealthy or not. And I wanted that kind of a family, that kind of characters that are they are not affected. They are as poor as they were before. A politician comes in this world. So why Salonta? Because as I said in the beginning, Salonta is my hometown, is the place where I started thinking about cinema, and I started to write stories about people in that particular town. And I like to do that, and I want to do that, because I think it's important that you tell stories about people you care about, and the people that you know about. It's for me, I'm not living there, I'm living in Bucharest, but for me it's keep connection with Salonta, and it's really easy to write and pleasant to write, because I talk with them and I go there and I pick up some stories and I drink some beers with them, and then I go back and then I think about what they told me. And that's how I built two or three scripts from this small talk and from my observation and imagining what if a politician from Bucharest will come in this guy's house, like my neighbor's house. And that's part of the script. So it's a game when you write and you imagine, and I'm connected with this place. So yeah, that's the motivation.
I like this idea of being a game. This was a really fascinating thank you for giving us this really fascinating insight into your process and opening up to talk about your connection with the story, your connection with the place where you shot the movie. Thank you so much. We invite everybody to, if you didn't see the movie, you really, really should. And these are the last 3 days of the festival, so make sure that you watch the movie. Marian is a really incredible storyteller, and he has an eye for actors, as we've established during this conversation, and for details. The details in the movie are absolutely amazing. We need to wrap up. Today is really packed with events for our festival. So I invite everybody who's watching us now to come to the Q&A with director Eugen Jebelanu on his movie Poppy Field. It's 12:30 Pacific time. So we'll see everybody there, and we'll see you all at the movies. Marian, thank you again for being with us today, for giving us your time, and for sharing all of these really great stories.
Thank you, and good luck with the festival.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Ciao, ciao.
Bye.
Toate bune.
Mulțumim.